Hi children, praise the Lord. How are you all? I hope everybody is fine by the grace of God. Even I am also fine by the grace of God. Children, I think you are all busy with this colorful Christmas celebration, isn't it? Yes. Didn't you buy new clothes? Yeah, I think you are all enjoying this, isn't it? Are you not awaiting for this program? Are you not be blessed with this program, children? I hope you are all enjoying this Sunday school program. I hope this Sunday school program is very helpful to you. Okay, right from lockdown was when lockdown was there. Right from then, now you are feeling boring, right? So we started this online Sunday school program, children, to make you to feel you happy and enjoy with this program. Okay, let's join our Sunday school program with a word of prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, we praise you for giving us another wonderful day in our life, God. My Jesus, you are the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. Our Heavenly Father, please be with us. You know you are very mighty and there is no one else in this world who can love you, who can love us like you, my God. You love us a lot because you have sacrificed your own life to us. Thank you for us for giving us this wonderful day in our life, and be with us, guide us, lead us, and you are the Lord who can help us, who can guide us. There is no one in this world. You are our best friend, you are a good teacher, you are a good healer, God. Please heal everyone who are suffering with diseases and all. Please, God, please be with us and guide us this program, and so that we can help our friends and all, we can guide and we can get all the members, all our friends to you, God. Please show us the right path. Please guide us in the right path. Please be with us in the first and the last, my God. In Jesus' name I ask and pray. Amen. Okay, children, by this online Sunday school program, it is an advantage. You can learn English. You can learn English Christian English Sunday school songs, so that you can improve your English your fluency. You can improve your fluency in English. Okay, children. Now today, last week I told you about King David, the friendship between the relationship between Jonathan. So this week I'm going to tell you about, who is that I'm going to tell you? He is none other than King Solomon. Do you know, children, he was God, you know, God has given much wisdom and knowledge. Nobody ever have that such wisdom God has given to King Solomon. Do you know one thing, children? King Solomon, he written 3,000 wise sayings, that is, we have in our Bible, is it? That is 3,000 proverbs he have written. He wrote nearly 1,000 songs. You know, such knowledge God has given to him. Yes, God, when it was a time for his father David to die, the God appeared to King Solomon, to the Solomon, and he asked, "My son, what did you want from me? What did I give? What shall I give to you?" But then when the God asked Solomon, he just told God, he just answered like this, My God, I am so young and so small, and you know, I should rule this kingdom, great kingdom. This is a vast and a very large kingdom. This is Israel kingdom. So I have to rule this. So to rule that, I need wisdom, I need knowledge. When he asked this, the God was very much pleased with his answer. And then God said, "I will also give what you haven't asked, what a big answer you have given for me." God was very much pleased with that, because he was, even in our life, when it happens, when God appears to us by sudden, by fortune, what we ask, children? Some members will ask aeroplanes, some members want to have bus, some members will ask helicopters, some members will ask cycles, you know, some members will ask toys, isn't it? So in the same way, when the God asked King Solomon, he said, "I need wisdom, my God, to rule this country, to rule this Israel." Then God has given him what he didn't ask. God said that we'll also have riches and a great honor so that anybody didn't have in this world. So God has given him such a big blessings and all. So children, the same way, it was a time for the testing of King Solomon's knowledge. So one day what happened? Two women came to King Solomon. One of them said like this, "My God, your majesty, myself and this woman live in the same house. One day I gave a birth to a baby boy where she was also there in my house and nobody was there. And 3 days later, she also gave to a baby boy." So that was happened like that. So we both live in that same house. Nobody will be there along with us. So it was happened like that. So one day what happened? One night, this woman rolled on over her own baby by mistake and found that that baby was dead. So when she found that the baby was dead, she carried my baby from my side and put that baby on her bed and kept her dead baby on my cot, on my bed. So the next morning, everything she done in very calm. The next morning, when it was time to nurse my baby, I found that the baby was dead. When I observed very closely to that baby, I found that that baby was not mine. That baby does not belong to me, my lord. When she was saying like this, the other woman said to King, no, she's saying lies. No, that dead baby is hers, the living child is mine. Then the first woman said, no, my God, she's saying lies. That living baby is only mine. The dead boy is hers. Then the King Solomon is saying like this, you both says that the living one belongs to me and the dead one belongs to the other one. So I will do a best solution for this. So God has given what knowledge, you know, this situation resembles, it indicates, it's, you know, this situation, this it predicts, it shows that how much wisdom God has given, such a godly wisdom God has given to him. So then King Solomon called, "You soldier, come here, cut the living baby into half, into two pieces, give each one half." Then when the king said like that, the soldier took that living baby and he was about to cut. When he was about to cut that baby, the real mother, who was full of love and affection towards her baby, she told King that, "No, don't, my king, don't kill that baby. Let that woman have that baby." Yeah, she said. But the other woman, what she said? "No, yes, she can cut that baby into two pieces so that anybody will not have that baby." Then the King Solomon understood who is a real mother, who is a kind-hearted mother. Then he understood that real mother who was full of love, who said that let that woman have that baby. When she said like that, then King Solomon understood that that baby belongs to that woman. She was a real mother. So King Solomon solved this situation in a very beautiful, it was amazing, right children? So then everybody in the kingdom, people, all the children, all members, elders and all, they were very much surprised by the knowledge of the King Solomon. So everybody praised the wisdom of King Solomon. Many people, many kings, even the Sheba queen also came to know the knowledge of the King Solomon. So you know children, so what did we learn from this? First, we need to obey the God. Yeah, when God appears to King Solomon, he also said that your father David, he is to obey all the commands and David, he used to worship me, he used to praise me. You know, he did not reject me. No, he loved me a lot, he praised me. And what is the first thing he did is, he given the first priority to God, to me in his life. So in that way, he became from the shepherd place to he kept him in a king place, in the king place God kept him. So in the same way, King Solomon also, he didn't ask for ornaments, diamonds, gold, silver, and for all those things he didn't ask God. He just asked the right thing, he asked, and moreover, he obeyed the God. He listened to the God. By that, he obeyed the commands of God. All the commands, whatever the Bible says, whatever the God said, that he used to obey the every command. So children, in that way, we have to obey the God. Obedience is very important. Obedience, honesty, you know, discipline. When we have discipline, then everything automatically comes to you, to us. Isn't it? The Bible says, the Proverbs says, you know, do you know who wrote the Proverbs? Yeah, as I told, the Proverbs was written by King Solomon. Thus, from the Proverbs 9th chapter, 10th verse says like this: the fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. So children, from the there are many stories, there are many lessons from the Bible which we can utilize in our life, which we can make use of them to move in a right path. So that, you know, there are many who become the prime ministers, who became the kings, who became the rulers of a vast kingdom. Do you know? So Joseph, who is a son of Jacob and Rahel, he became a minister. God has put him such a great place. So what he did? He did not disobey the God's commands. He always, you know, when the time comes to do a mistake, or when the situation was not right, we should not be disobedient. We should always be obedient. We should not shout. We should not quarrel with anyone. We should not fight. If you are doing these fightings, quarreling, shouting, lying, this all belongs to, do you know who? This all who belongs to who? Yeah, this all belongs to Satan. Got it, children? So don't be a friend of Satan. Be a friend of Jesus. Then you will be like King Solomon. You like a King David, like Joseph and the Daniel in the Bible, who achieved the greatest heights in their life by listening to the, by obeying to the God's word. Okay, children. So today the promise of the day is, fear of the Lord is a beginning of knowledge. Proverbs 9th chapter 10th verse. So always read the Bible every day, pray every day. Okay, you have to always do prayer. You have to read your Bible every day. If you don't know how to read the Bible, ask your mother or your father to memorize you that memory verses. Okay, children, so that you will be blessed. God will give you much wisdom and the knowledge when you obey to the God's word. Okay, thank you, children. Bye.